I've seen some cool images floating around on Pinterest lately that combine everyday photos with neon lights to create contemporary art pieces. In today's tutorial, we're going to create a similar colourful neon sign effect that enhances a typical photo with an integral message, all tied together with a colourful glow that seems to illuminate the surrounding scene. To begin, we first need a background photo to use as the foundation of the piece. Images of jungle foliage are pretty common, so I'm using this free photo from unsplash.com. You can use neon shapes to draw attention to certain areas of a photo or art piece, or use a word or quote to give the image a core message. To make the text look somewhat like a neon sign, it must be set using a mono-weight font. Script fonts in particular look great. I'm using Neon Noir from the Adobe Fonts library. Alter the size and layout of the text so it fits into the scene. Press Command or Control on Windows and T to transform, then right click and choose Skew. Drag the handle on the right upwards by 10 degrees to give the text a rise effect. Scale and position the text, paying attention to the surrounding elements that could be made to overlap the text to give a sense of depth. Let's add a bunch of layer styles to produce the neon glow effect. Double click the layer to open the layer style options. Begin with a colour overlay and choose the colour of your neon tube. Since this neon is being placed against jungle leaves, a vibrant green is a good choice. Add an inner glow layer style next. Change the colour to white and then check the centre option so the glow emits from the middle rather than the edge. Bring up the opacity to see the effect more clearly. Then change the blending mode to linear dodge. Zoom in and alter the size figure so the green colouring can still be seen at the edges of the neon tube. In the contour option, choose the half round profile to make the colour change more abrupt. Add an outer glow next. Set up the colour with a similar green to the original tube. Change the blending mode to linear dodge, then bring up the opacity while the other options are being set. Increase the size to take away the hard edges of the tube. Around 10 pixels will do. Bring down the opacity to around 60% to fine-tune the appearance. Add a drop shadow and change the blending mode to overlay. Set the angle to 90 degrees so the shadow is placed directly underneath. Increase the size to around 30 pixels, then the distance to around 10 pixels so the shadow just creeps from underneath the text. We've already used the outer glow option and it's not an effect you can duplicate. Instead, we can add an extra drop shadow and convert it into a glow style effect. Change the color to a green to match the tubes, then set the blending mode to linear dodge. Reduce the distance to zero, then bring up the size to around 50 pixels to layer up a slightly larger glow. Reduce the opacity to around 75%. Add another drop shadow. This time bring up the size to around 135 pixels and set the opacity to 50%. Layering up glows like this helps retain the vibrancy near the tubes while still having a large ambient glow around them. Okay these layer style settings to see the neon light effect. Add a layer mask to the text layer and set up the brush tool with a round tip and fairly high hardness. Make sure the flow setting is at 100%. Begin painting with black over the areas you want to erase to give the impression that they're hidden behind a leaf. Pan around the canvas by holding the space bar while clicking and dragging. Erasing these portions of the text helps make it appear part of the scene rather than being overlaid on top of the image. If you ever need to restore the neon text, switch the foreground color to white and paint back in the mask. Carefully select the areas you want to conceal. You don't want to go too overboard and not be able to read what the text actually says. Now let's continue adding some effects to the background to tie the neon glow with the scene. In the adjustments layer menu, add a photo filter. Choose Cooling Filter 82 from the preset list, then bring up the density to 60%. Currently this adjustment layer is affecting the background and the neon text, so click and drag the layer between the two layers in the layer stack. Add a new layer which will be placed above the photo filter but below the text. Use the Alt and Backspace shortcut to fill it with black. Change the blending mode to soft light, then bring down the opacity to around 20%. Add a subtle vignette using a gradient adjustment layer. Using the default black to transparent gradient profile, change the style to radial then check reverse so it flows the right way. Increase the scale to around 250 so it gradually flows in from the canvas edges. Add a gradient map next. We need to alter the colours using the eyedropper, but it won't work if the layer mask is selected. Make sure to first activate the actual gradient map icon in the layer, then you can click the white swatch and eyedropper green from the artwork. Drag this gradient swatch towards the middle to add a bright green ambience to the photo. Change this layer's blending mode to colour dodge, which will boost the colours in the highlights. It can blow out the brightest parts, so reduce the fill setting in the layers panel to around 70% to tone it down. Add one more layer, then change the foreground colour by eyedropping a green hue from the scene. Grab the brush tool again and set up the tip with zero hardness. Bring down the flow amount so you can build up the colour with multiple clicks. Dab spots of green around the neon text to add more ambient glow to the surrounding areas. Change this layer to overlay with 50% opacity so it acts as a subtle colour cast. The final result is a colourful neon sign effect that combines two visual themes you wouldn't expect to see together. Using Photoshop layer styles, we created a vibrant neon glow effect, which was then tied in with the surrounding areas by simulating ambient glows and highlights. If you enjoyed this tutorial or learnt any new tricks, a thumbs up on the video to help recommend it to others would be greatly appreciated. Subscribe to the channel to stick around for more content, and be sure to head over to my Spoon Graphics website to bag yourself my free design resources bundle. As always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.